Chelsea moving the ball forward. What can they do from here? And a penalty awarded. Spot kick coming up. Chance maybe to settle this. And he finds the net. No difficulties encountered.
Well, here we can see it again, and he's done well to read the intentions. Just can't get a touch on it as it sails over him. So close to being a fantastic stop.
Away once more, 2-0 the lead here. Egan. On the ball, Davis. Traore. Sheffield United couldn't keep it. Nicolas Gonzalez. No, they need to get tighter. They keep plugging away. Oh, that's not a good clearance. Decides to shoot. And still danger here. Not a time for composure on the ball. And Chelsea get the decision from the referee. Target, but robust defending. The electronic board has been held in the air, and we're going to have a minimum of 4 added minutes. Well, the referee wasn't going to let that go. Jackson on the ball. Intercepted. And fed forwards. Well, that cross was more than acceptable, but they couldn't fire at home. Gustavo Hammer. Max Lowe on the ball. So the final whistle, and what we can say officially now is that Chelsea have picked up maximum points from this fixture.
Well, Derek, it's a comfortable...
day is here. The match everyone has been talking about, and with good reason. Two teams of strong pedigree, rich in talent, on the cusp of going head-to-head in a highly significant confrontation with so much to play for. How will it pan out? Hello and a warm welcome from the English West Midlands. We find ourselves at Molineux. I'm Derek Ray, and sharing commentary with me, as usual, is Stuart Robson. And very much looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League. It's Wolverhampton Wanderers taking on Chelsea.
Well, thanks, Derek. The best coach I played under would always tell us before kick-off, earn the right to play. If you can...
Well, a bit naughty, that challenge, so early in the contest. Interesting to see what the referee's going to do about it. Well, you don't really want to be picking up a caution so early in the game, Stuart.
Well, he's going to be under pressure now. That was a reckless challenge. He didn't need to make it at all.
Parejo. Good run. Very much in control of the situation. Opportunity! Surely now. Parejo. With news of a goal in the Luton game, it's over to Alex Scott. Alex.
It's a goal for Newcastle. Could the goalkeeper have done better? Yes, but let's not take nothing away from that finish. It's now 1-0 with 5 minutes on the clock.
Alex with the info as ever. Chelsea did more than enough in their win against Sheffield United. How might this one go, Stuart?
Well, that 2-0 victory at home was not as easy as the scoreline suggests. They were just better in both boxes. And when you look at the two teams today, I'd expect them to win again. They should be too strong for their opponents here.
Wang Yi-chan. Good work from Chelsea to win back possession. Side low on confidence in front of goal. Just look at their statistics. They have the worst attack in the league, Stuart.
Well, I'm not surprised by their lack of goals. Their approach play is far too predictable. It lacks invention and guile, which makes it almost impossible for the forwards to find space. And I can't see that changing today.
Oh, sorry, Stuart, look at this. Nicely saved. Corner kick played in. Of support here. Can he put them in front? That's a routine take. Chelsea will get the throw in. Sterling. Well, that's wonderful attacking play. Quick thinking defensively. Nelson Semedo. Jean Vigneur Pelgar. Trying to open up the defence. And turns it through. Well, what an opportunity that was.
Well, that's a great chance to open the scoring. It's a poor effort in the end.
Mateus Cunha. Plenty of support here. To take the lead! Well, it didn't really go according to the script, did it?
Well, the less said about that, the better, because that's a really poor attempt in the end.
Well, Thiago Silva. Madueke. Released it nicely. Showing real patience. Can they forge ahead? Real chance. Cleared away. Jean Vigneur Bergard. Oh, no stopping him. And threading it through. Straight forward for the keeper. Parejo. Bad challenge, and now it's up to the referee in terms of what to do next. And a yellow card it's going to be, Stuart.
Yeah, the ref got that right. It's a yellow card all day long.
Keo. Effective challenge. Wang Hee-chan. We're using the space really well, but now can they push on? And fed forwards. Well, he stopped it out of there without much fuss. Counter-attacking chance. Need to get back quickly here. Keo. Just the challenge that was required. Oh, in with a chance! And it's in! 1-0! They breached the defence!
Well, this is a very exciting finish, as you can see. He's under so much pressure, but his strength just allows him to hit through the ball cleanly. It's an excellent goal.
Pablo Sarabia. Bergard. Successfully cut out. Chilwell. Sterling. Played through by Sterling. But they got nothing out of it. Chance maybe to use their counter-attacking ability to good effect. Well, it could be on for him here. Oh, couldn't beat the goalkeeper, and really should have been able to. Keo. The goal to update you on in the Villa game. Alex Scott will tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Villa. They're back level. It's 1-0 with 41 minutes on the clock.
Alex, thank you very much. Nelson Semedo really getting stuck in. It's a good looking ball. And the referee blows for a foul. Sloppy Carvajal. Nelson Semedo. Be 1 minute added on at the end. Parejo. No more time left. That will conclude the first half here at Molineux. Trailing after the first half, and they find a response here in the second. Well, the outcome is a free kick here. We're making considerable progress with the ball. Just leaning back a bit and over the bar. Jackson on the ball. Carvajal. Very alert defending to put a stop to the chance. Wang Ki-chan. Can he finish? Pretty routine there for the goalkeeper. We always enjoy bringing you live action on EA TV and Premier League action coming up. It's Wolves facing Brentford. Unable to hold on for the ball. The referee wasn't going to let that go. Substitution then. Let's see how it affects the match. And the keeper grabbing hold of that free kick. And a throw in here for Wolves. Promising pass. Oh, the threat is there. Well, not very clever defending. A cross there that was decidedly ordinary. Can he finish? Oh, that's a fine save.
Well, it's been a while, but these fans are now coming to life. Can they equalise here?
He's driven in the corner.
Here you can see it again. It's a superb cross, just asking for someone to go and meet it. And then what a great finish as well. Good connection with the ball, leaving the keeper with little chance. It's a great goal.
Underway, level pegging, one goal apiece in this game. The timing was perfect, ball one. Fernandez. Keogh. Attacking possibilities for Chelsea. Good work by Wolves to get it back. ...30 minutes to go then. Well, this is the home of live football, EA TV, and we have more action coming up from the Premier League for you. It's Chelsea facing Crystal Palace.
That looks a really entertaining game. Two good teams with two excellent coaches. I can't wait for that one to come round.
Chance perhaps. He's blocked it. Not giving him a moment's peace. The referee spotted the infringement and it will be a free kick in a position of genuine menace. And the play stopped. They will make the change now. A very fine piece of tackling. Mateus Cunha. And a foul in the opinion of the referee. Now, what can they do from this free kick situation? Well, that's not one for his personal scrapbook, I think it's safe to say.
Well, the manager will be absolutely furious. It's a waste of a good situation. He won't be on the next one, that's for sure.
Situation has changed in the City game. Alex Scott is going to tell us more.
Yeah, it's a third goal for Manchester City. They're now 3 ahead with 68 minutes played.
Thanks as always to Alex Scott. Keogh. Making considerable progress with the ball. Ball is loose. And into the last 20 minutes. This might be ideal for the counter. Nelson Semedo. A real opening now. Well, quite simply, that is a wasted chance. Cucurella might be able to set up the chance. Oh, how about that for the last line of defence? Right, from what I'm hearing, there's been a goal in the Luton match. Let's send it over to Alex for the details.
And it's a goal for Newcastle United. You could see he knew what he wanted to do as he stepped up to take that free kick, because it was executed superbly.
Oh, jumping in. They're in a great position here. Oh, a challenge that simply had to be won. Well, as you'll have noticed, we had to cut Alex a bit short just then. To confirm, Newcastle United have scored in that match. And they are seemingly cruising now, 3-0 in front. Free kick to Chelsea. And they're going to alter things. Here's the substitution. Longstaff. Really good challenge. Still level, but Chelsea on the attack near the end. Longstaff. Lemina. Extremely sloppy in possession. And news of a goal at the Etihad Stadium. Alex Scott.
It's a goal for Brentford. The defender was caught in possession just before the goal. He won't want to be watching that back. They've pulled one back and now trail by one. 80 minutes played. This is what we love to see. Back to you, Derek.
Alex with the info as ever. And there the move ends for now. Wolves in a position of menace. Well, didn't go to plan in the end. Parejo. Cucurella. Wonderfully weighted pass. Good defending, clattered out of there. A textbook interception. Mateus Cunha. Enzo Fernandez. Nice weight on the pass. Can he finish? Wins it for them. There's every chance, and the fans are lapping this up.
Well, here it is again, and what a perfect cross into the box this is. Just invited someone to attack it, and he makes the finish look so easy. What a good goal that is.
Going to happen next? Well, wait, don't go anywhere. We're going to have 5 additional minutes. distribution. Takes some progress with the ball at his feet. Well, the cross needed to be better than that one. Sound piece of goalkeeping. Could be threatening. It's still alive. Well, nothing comes on the attack when all is said and done. Oh, really careless. They might be in. So the final whistle now. It goes down as a victory for Chelsea, to the delight of their fans.
Eric, well, it could have gone either way, couldn't it? It's so competitive for much...
on one man. Will he add to his total of 4 goals from his last 3? Hello everyone, great to be with you from Stamford Bridge. I'm Derek Ray, perched here on the commentary gantry, and sitting alongside me to provide expert analysis is Stuart Robson. And it's all about action from the Premier League in this case. It is Chelsea up against Crystal Palace.
Well, thanks, Derek, as always. The scene is set, 2 good teams, great playing surface, and a vibrant atmosphere. It has all the ingredients for a really exciting game.
He just needs to stay level-headed there. Well, we always try to be fair about it, but that really should have been 1-0 early on here.
Well, what a chance. That would have been a great start for them.
Here's the lineup for Chelsea. Carvajal starts with Ben Chilwell in the fullback positions, and rather than use a strike partnership, they've gone with just the one player in attack. Well, it could be on for him here, and the goalkeeper's touch, that was crucial. A Chelsea corner. Well, when they go in, it looks spectacular. When they don't go in, you know the rest.
Yeah, it's a difficult bit of skill, and on this occasion, he got it all wrong.
Chelsea were richly praised for their win against Wolverhampton Wanderers. How do you anticipate it going this time, Stuart?
That away victory was a really good performance. Today we'll follow a similar pattern, and I expect them to win by the odd goal.
Plenty of support here. Well, it came to nothing in the end. Always difficult to predict in advance who might decide a game, but you could make a strong case for this man, I think, Stuart. What are you expecting to see from him?
Well, Derek, his outstanding attribute is his pace. Not just over the first few yards, but over longer distances as well. And that makes him so difficult to play against. Defenders are unsure whether to get tight or drop off. A dynamic player.
Well, to win the ball back. opponent. He's waiting in the middle. This could have possibilities. And still danger here. They keep plugging away. Threatening the goalkeeper, and he'll be disappointed. And news of a goal at Goodison Park. Alex Scott has the details for us.
It's a goal for Manchester City. They're back level. It's 1-0 with 16 minutes played.
Alex with the info as ever. Rather than a free kick, it's advantage Chelsea. It's looking promising. Can they take the lead? A goal! On the back of sustained pressure. Now they deservedly hold the advantage.
Well, let's take another look, and it's a very good goal. They deserve it, you have to say. They've been excellent.
And they get the ball moving again. Can Palace come up with an answer here? Klein.
What a superb volley this is. He strikes it so cleanly and he times it perfectly.
So back underway with the lead standing at 2-0. Attacking possibilities for Palace. And a chance to whip it in here. A no-nonsense clearance. Chance maybe to use their counter-attacking ability to good effect. Well, it fizzled out. Cheikh Doucouré. Can he find the right pass? And in a perfect position to cut it out. Chelsea in a position of menace. Fine reading of the situation. Jean-Philippe Mateta. And news from St. James's Park. There's been a goal there. That means we send it over to Alex Scott.
Yeah, another goal for Newcastle United. They're back in this now with 28 minutes played.
Alex keeping us right up to date. Trouble them here, being egged on by the crowd.
Oh, and it goes! Now he has his hat-trick, a special moment for him.
Well, as you can see, this is absolutely brilliant. He's such a good runner with the ball, and it's a great individual goal. Brilliant from him.
First half display, and just look at that score. Chances on. Oh, magical piece.
great save there. Such good reactions. It really is.
Well, using the space really well, you've got to say. Attacking play, crossed in there.
Oh, a goal! How about that for a degree of difficulty? Simply off the charts!
So back underway at 3-1. Kio. Mikhailo Mudrik. I must say, this looks promising. But nothing comes of it. Good defending it was. Cheikh Doucouré. This is Klein. Players waiting in the centre. Opportunity here. Oh, the flag's gone up, and there wasn't much in that. Towards the interval, and it's going with home advantage. Stuart, as always, very keen to get your take.
Yes, it's been a really energetic display from them so far. The passing's been sharp, the movement from the front players has been excellent, and the finishing has been clinical. They will certainly be happy going in at half time.
The Chelsea move still flowing. They were playing fluid football, but then the foul, and now you would anticipate a yellow card. And that is going to mean a caution.
The referee is absolutely right. He knew what he was doing there.
And the keeper flings himself at the ball. Played over. A bit wasteful from Palace. Philippe Mateta. Going well. What about the stop? Wonderful chance. Timely intervention. First half draws to a close here in West London. So back in business here, and Chelsea dominating the proceedings in the first half of this game. Will we see a similar pattern in the second 45? Cut out. Now what can they do with the ball? Now breaking at pace is always a possibility. And able to close down the shot. Substitution time it is here. Who can he pick out? On the corner. Too close to the goalkeeper that time. Badiashil. Don't forget, we have more live action from the Premier League coming up here on EA TV. It's Chelsea versus Luton Town.
I'm really looking forward to that. Two entertaining teams in what should be a really feisty affair.
Keeper did his job to begin with. And problem solved for now. Sloppy with the ball, Nathaniel Clyne. Almost just weighing up the opposition with a string of neat passes. And playing it through. Looking as though there might be a threat, but not so in the end. Good defending. Play for what will be a Chelsea throw. Well, when you sit off like this, you invite pressure. Keogh delivered into the area here, and that's fantastic goalkeeping to get across and deal with the danger. Over it comes. No end product. The importance of that tackle cannot be overstated. Fairly easy for the referee to spot that deflection, so now a throw in.
Well, as the stats confirm, Chelsea have controlled the ball. Yes, they've played well when going forward, but it's been their ability to regain the ball that's made them so hard to play against here, and it makes them such a good team. It's been a brilliant performance so far.
Time tackle. Can they do something positive on the counter attack? Can they make it count? Will the cross work out for them? Ah, goalkeeper's ball. Not the best of crosses, really, was it? Mudrik. Just getting word that something has happened at St James's Park. Let's find out what. Here's Alex.
And it's a goal for Newcastle United. It was a nice 1-2, and then he coolly slotted it around the goalkeeper. They've pulled one back with 63 minutes
left. Sorry, Alex, could be a goal here. What a vital intervention. Well, apologies for interrupting, Alex. To clarify, Newcastle did find the net in that game, and their lead stands at 3-1. Read it superbly to take back possession. Cheikh Doucouré. For more on the injury, let's go down to our reporter, Jeff Shreves.
Well, it's a real concern, looks from the bench, I have to tell you, because he's landed right on top of his elbow, and that's causing him some serious pain at the moment.
Cheers, Jeff. Just a reminder, we have more absorbing action from the Premier League coming your way here on EA TV. It's Crystal Palace facing Brentford.
Well, Derek, I'm really looking forward to it. Always a great atmosphere in that stadium, and it should be an entertaining match.
This looks more than decent. And it's a long way off target, you've got to say. They will now make use of the substitutes bench. Keogh. Certainly not alone. Might work out. And a heartless cross gobbled up. Cheikh Doucouré. Well, goal news to bring you from the Everton game. Alex Scott has the details.
It's a goal for Manchester City. It was a low-driven cross into a crowded area, but he was there from close range to...
Can he finish? Full credit. Wonderful stop. We're inside the final 15 minutes. Silva. Well, hit with power and almost the right precision. And the substitution will occur now. Clean challenge. Ezzy. Mitchell. Following that challenge. Jairo Riedewald. Oh, he's given it away. Oh, breezing past him. About the outcome, surely they now have been removed. Oh, he's beaten his opponent. Well, going for power, but what can you say about it, really? Not great. Chilwell. Good bit of closing down. Timed his challenge magnificently. Ezzy. Oh, without putting too fine a point on it, he's missed it. Now they're going to alter things. Here's the substitution. But in the closing phase, and Stuart, Chelsea have been tremendous today.
Well, what can you say about this performance? They've been absolutely brilliant. They've played with such guile and creativity, and their passing has been so expansive. Not many teams would have stopped them today.
Jean-Philippe Mateta. Real chance. And tried to place it with only the keeper to beat.
Well, I have to say, I never really fancied him to score there. That was a golden opportunity.
Nkunku. We will have a couple of additional minutes at the end here. Nkunku has it. And nicely over the top. Bad place to lose the ball. Oh, beating his opponent with ease. And that is that. The referee brings this match to an end and Chelsea get the 3 points. What did you make of their performance as a whole?
Well, Derek, they were the better team all over the pitch. We saw good individual performances. We saw an attack which was always threatening and they played really well. What a performance that was today.
focus of attention. Four goals last time out. Can he light up the stage again? You're watching EA TV. Football with the floodlights beaming down. I'm Derek Ray, and sitting next to me with his tactics charts. And here's how it looks for Chelsea. Carvajal starts with Ben Chilwell in the fullback positions, and in this tactical setup, they have just the one player in attack. And the cross not quite accurate enough. Chelsea were richly praised for their win against Crystal Palace. What do you expect this time around, Stuart?
Well, they were so clinical in front of goal, weren't they? What I liked.
Can he make it 1-0? And the penalty is converted. A goal it is. And now he can exhale.